Out the house with a yard sale, but you can't just throw everything outside and put up a few signs.
No, you need to plan and strategize for the best neighborhood yard sale. So Ken's got more with 5 tips on having a yard sale in today's Manly
Minute. It's all about strategery, people.
Strategery.
Hey, yeah, so this is kind of a cool thing. We're not really doing one by ourselves. We're doing one with our neighbors. So doing a yard sale coming up. And so I'm doing a little research, and hey, these are all the tips to make sure that you have the most successful yard sale you could possibly have, and you got to get it going soon. First thing you need to do, you got to conquer that clutter. And it's going to take you a while. We've actually been preparing for about 2 months. That means going into the closets, going into the garage, going to the shed if you have it, and just start clearing all that stuff out. First, you have to clear it out. Then you have to start separating and deciding what goes where. But in order to conquer that clutter, you got to get started way in advance before you do the yard sale. Can't do it the weekend of. You'll never, ever get through it. Number two, keep it clean. All right, so when you bring everything out, you have a lot of stuff that's in storage, right? It's got dust all over it. It may need a little bit of sprucing up. So make sure you clean everything up, shine it up, make it look good. We already know that it's used. It's a yard sale. But when people show up, they don't want to look at it and see, oh yeah, that's used. You just used that today. Clean the dust and stuff off of there so it seems like it's something that someone would want to buy. Number three, you gotta get the word out. And getting the word out can start with social media, maybe a week in advance to give people a heads up on social media, and then 2 days, 48 hours before you have that yard sale, that's when the signs go up on the street corners and the signs and out in front of your yard to give those folks who kind of walk through the neighborhood in the evenings a chance to know, hey, it's going to be a yard sale, because they want to come to the yard sale early in the morning, which is when you're going to be starting. But you got to get that word out way in advance. All right, now you've got your yard sale. How do you put everything out? Well, think like a merchandiser. And what does a merchandiser do? They take all the really big, high dollar value items, and they kind of put them out in front. So do all of that. Get the big things, put it in front to entice people to come in, separate the smaller things over to the side. Think like a merchandiser. Put things out that are going to attract people to come on in, look a little bit more in your yard sale. And the last thing, you do not have time to haggle. Everything has to go. That's the point of the yard sale. How are you going to sit out there and be like, oh no, that's worth more than that, when you're trying to get rid of it? Whatever they want to pay, just get rid of it. That's the whole point of the yard sale. And if you happen to make some money in return, bonus. But the first thing, everything must go. So don't bother with haggling or being sentimental about certain things at the last minute. It's too late for that. That's 5 tips to hopefully help you have a very successful yard sale with you and your neighbors. To find out more, go to gooddaysacramento.com. Click on show info for today's date. And man up for making a little money on your yard sale. Good Day continues after this. This is amazing.